Dear students, in today's class, I will going to continue the remaining part of the making of German nation or unification of Germany. In my previous class, I started discussing about the works of Bismarck. Through his blood and iron policy, he achieved the unification of Germany. And he also fought 3 wars to complete the unification work. So about the war with Denmark, we already discussed. So here we have another war which was fought by Bismarck to complete the work of unification of Germany, that is Austro-Prussian War or War with Austria. Austro-Prussian War or War with Austria. This war was fought in the year 1866. Having secured the Schleswig and Holstein, Prussia and Austria had to decide who was to rule them. By defeating Denmark, Schleswig and Holstein, these were the 2 duchies or 2 states of Germany, were secured by Austria and Prussia. A temporary solution was arrived at in the Convention of Gastein. According to the Convention of Gastein, Schleswig and Holstein would be jointly occupied by Prussia and Austria. The 2 partners, that is Prussia and Austria, had from the beginning regarded each other with suspicion and hostility. Before starting the war with Austria, Bismarck took care to keep away other European powers from supporting Austria. Here Bismarck, he wanted to defeat Austria also, because his only ambition was to achieve unification of Germany. And here one of the biggest obstacle towards this process was Austria. So he wanted to fought a war with Austria. So in order to defeat Austria, he keep away other European nations or powers from supporting Austria. Having isolated Austria, Bismarck now provoked Austria to war, declaring that Austria had violated the Convention of Gastein. Bismarck at once dispatched Prussian troops to occupy Holstein. He also promised compensation to Napoleon III, the ruler of France. At that time, the ruler of France was Napoleon III, for the French neutrality in the case of a war with Austria. He also promised some compensation to a French ruler, that is Napoleon III, for his neutrality in case of a war with Austria. Prussia and Italy also came to a secret understanding to help militarily each other if Austria attacked either of them, because the ambition of both nations, that is Italy and Germany, was the same. Both wanted to achieve unification. So they came to a secret understanding in order to help militarily each other against Austria. And after making all these arrangements, Prussia and Italy started troop movements near the Austrian borders. They started their troop movements, that is military activities, near the Austrian borders. Austria responded by full-scale mobilization of troops. The border incidents arranged by Bismarck made Austria to declare war on Prussia. When military movements were started near the borders of Austria, it made Austrians to declare a war against Prussia or against Bismarck. It also resulted in the reluctant German states joining the Prussian side because of German nationalistic sentiments. Many German states voluntarily joined the side of Prussia because of their nationalistic sentiments or aspirations. The well-prepared Prussian army, with the support of Italy and many German states, registered quick victories in various battles against Austria. Here Prussia and Austria fought each other, and in many battles Prussians defeated Austrians. The decisive battle was fought at Sadowa. Between Austria and Prussia. In this battle, Austria was completely defeated. And this war is also called as 7 Years' War. The battle which was fought at Sadowa is also called as the 7 Years' War. And result of this war was Austria was completely defeated. The Austro-Prussian War of 1866 ended with the Treaty of Prague, and according to this treaty, Schleswig and Holstein were annexed by Prussia to German states, which were jointly administered by Austria and Prussia, were annexed by Prussia after the Austro-Prussian War. Austria also agreed to give up the supervision of the German states. The North German Confederation was formed under the leadership of the Prussian king. This resulted in a partial unification of Germany. So this is about the Austro-Prussian War. And after this war, Bismarck fought another decisive battle, and the name of that battle is Franco-Prussian War, or War with France. This war was fought in the year 1870-71. Bismarck did not keep up the promise of compensation to France for his neutrality during the Austro-Prussian War. He desired a war with France to complete his scheme of unification. So here Bismarck knew that a war with France would make the remaining German states to join the North German Confederation. After the Austro-Prussian War, already North German Confederation was formed, but some German states were remained outside this confederation. So to achieve the full process of unification, a war with France also necessary, that is according to Bismarck. So here the balance of power which existed in Europe was shattered due to the Austrian defeat. When Austria was defeated by Prussia in the year 1866, that balance of power which was existed in Europe, which was disturbed. After the Vienna Congress of 1815, this Austria started dominating over European continent, but later it was shattered. So France too wanted a war with Prussia. The dispute for the Spanish throne offered a pretext for war. A civil war was started in Spanish, and that became a pretext for the Franco-Prussian War. Bismarck supported the claims of Prince Leopold, a relative of the Prussian king, whereas the French were alarmed at the growth of the Prussian power. So the ruler of France, Napoleon III, declared war on Prussia. When Prussia became very strong, and it also started interfering in the other nations' affairs, here Napoleon III, the ruler of France, declared a war on Prussia. Bismarck diplomatically isolated France in the war. He already made some arrangements to isolate France. So he diplomatically isolated France. None of the European states or nations came to the support of France. The South German states which had remained out of the North German Confederation joined Prussia against France. So some of the South German states which were under the control of France were also voluntarily joined the North German Confederation. The Prussian forces inflicted crushing defeats at different places to France. The Battle of Sedan, fought on 1st September 1870, was the final blow to the France. A decisive battle was fought between France and Prussia, and the name of that battle was Battle of Sedan, and this completely defeated France. This defeated France, and the after this battle, Napoleon III, the Emperor of France, was captured. With this, the unification of Germany was completed. With the defeat of France, the unification of Germany was completed. After this unification, or after the completion of the unification of Germany, William was crowned as the Emperor of Unified Germany. King William was crowned as the Emperor of Unified Germany. And he also assumed the title Kaiser, and he was popularly became Kaiser William, means ruler of Germany. Bismarck, he became the Chancellor or Prime Minister of Unified Germany. He was appointed as the Prime Minister or Chancellor of Unified Germany. In 1871, after the unification, after the completion of the unification movement, in 1871, a treaty was signed by the French leaders with Prussia, known as the Treaty of Frankfurt. This is a very important treaty which was signed between France and Austria in the year 1871, and the name of the treaty is the Treaty of Frankfurt. According to the treaty, France agreed to surrender Alsace and Lorraine. According to the Treaty of Frankfurt, France agreed to surrender Alsace and Lorraine. These are the two territories or provinces of Germany, and also they agreed to pay a war indemnity of 5 billion francs to Germany. France also agreed to pay 5 billion francs to Germany. This is according to the Treaty of Frankfurt. So here, because of the works or because of the policy of Otto von Bismarck, that is blood and iron, he achieved the goal of Germans, that is the unification of Germany, and he also became the Chancellor of Unified Germany. So this is about the unification of Germany, and because of his efforts, he also became the architect of German unification. So students, this is all about the unification movement of Germany or making of the German nation. Vidyarthigale, nodi ili 1870-71 ee varshadalli Germany enakide unified aagide. ಮತ್ತೆ ಜರ್ಮನಿಯು ಏಕೀಕರಣಗೊಳ್ಳಕ್ಕೆ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಕಾರಣಕರ್ತ ಆಟೋ ವನ್ ಬಿಸ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್. ಅವನು ತನ್ನ ರಕ್ತ ಮತ್ತು ಉಕ್ಕಿನ ನೀತಿಯಿಂದ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಜರ್ಮನಿಯನ್ನು ಒಟ್ಟುಗೂಡಿಸ್ತಾನೆ ಅಥವಾ ಜರ್ಮನಿಯನ್ನು ಏಕೀಕರಣ ಕರಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಈ ಜರ್ಮನಿಯನ್ನು ಏಕೀಕರಣಗೊಳಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಥವಾ ಜರ್ಮನಿಯ ಏಕೀಕರಣವನ್ನು ಪೂರ್ಣಗೊಳಿಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಸ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಮೂರು ಯುದ್ಧಗಳನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಾರ್ ವಿತ್ ಡೆನ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್, ಡೆನ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ನೊಂದಿಗೆ ಯುದ್ಧ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಾದೊಂದಿಗೆ ಯುದ್ಧ. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಫ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ನೊಂದಿಗೆ ಯುದ್ಧ. ಈ ಮೂರು ಯುದ್ಧಗಳನ್ನು ನಡೆಸುವುದರ ಮೂಲಕ ಬಿಸ್ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಜರ್ಮನಿಯ ಏಕೀಕರಣವನ್ನು ಪೂರ್ಣಗೊಳಿಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಮತ್ತು ಜರ್ಮನಿಯ ಏಕೀಕರಣದ ಶಿಲ್ಪಿ ಅಂತವನನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕರೆಯುತ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಯುನಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಜರ್ಮನಿ. Thank you, students.